It's got to be, it's a window seat reality.
Is this it?
I guess so. I can't tell you if you draw the picture. I don't know. It's a window seal down there, a ledge down there. Mm-hmm. It has to be down there. You showed it to me. So you know I'm down there.
That's it.
I'm telling you the truth.
This is where the location where you killed it?
That's down, it's downstairs.
Just downstairs, right below here.
Right there is where she was. Right there, right? It's a drain right there. Mm-hmm. Right there. Her hand was on that wall. I passed it up. I can see how she was laying. Her foot was on the step, right here. Her belly was on the step. This hand was up on the wall. And she was like this. She was sitting. She had her head on her arm like this.
Okay, why was she sniffing? Why was she sniffing? Why was she sniffing?
She was as scared as me. I guess she was crying.
She was crying?
I guess I don't know because I didn't see her face.
Just before you hit?
Not that bad.
After you hit? She was sniffing?
Yeah, she was.
After you hit her? Or before you hit her?
After I hit it, because she said...
Was it after you pushed her down and stuff?
She said, my mommy. Like that. Just like start crying.
That's what she said.
Start crying. She said, my mommy. I remember that
time. You remember that?
She said, my mommy. She said, mommy.
She called for her mommy.
She wasn't dead, though.
She wasn't that type of girl that you usually mess with. But she called for her mom.
Fuck me up, too, man.
Huh?
Fuck me up too. Just kill me, man.
You're stating that her clothes were up.
Her clothes were on.
What'd you do with the pole?
I threw it down.
Threw it down where?
I have no idea.
You didn't carry it out, you said.
I don't know, I think so. I was scared when I hear. She said, mommy, I just started crying. Yeah. Hold on, I knew what I did.
This was after you had hit
him. I think I threw the pole. Yeah, I threw the pole down.
Where?
It's somewhere down there.
On top of her?
No.
Next to her?
I guess I threw it this way, because I couldn't throw it to her. I threw it down. I know I threw it down. I know I did.
So again, Hernandez, you wanted her. You were looking for sex. You went ahead, you got her downstairs, you pulled her pants down, and you took it from her. Now, obviously you took it from her and she didn't like it. She's trying to get out. Because you even said you were scared. You were scared of being caught.
After that happened, no, I was scared.
So why would you allow her?
Coming behind her, I pushed her back. Okay. She fell. I looked at her.
So her pants weren't up, were they?
Yeah.
Her pants weren't up.
Were up.
No, they weren't.
Okay. Now you're trying to tie me up. We've been friends all this time. Now you're trying to tie me up.
I'm just going with the evidence.
Her pants were up.
Was this?
I know her pants.
Look at that.
I left her pants up.
You didn't leave her pants up. That's how you left her. That's how you left her. But you did that to her. You hit her with that punch. Is that what you did to her? I don't want to hear guess so again. I'm sorry?
Yes.
How many times did you hit her?
Two or three.
Two or three? Could it be three or four? Nice sized girl. I'm just asking. Nice sized girl. See, at this point in time, you're panicking at this point. You know what I'm saying?
I know, I don't know.
And I want to leave that option open to you. I mean, how many times? You was telling us it was once or twice. In our line of work, once or twice is just the beginning. Okay? Two times, that's enough. But when you say it two or three, then that's more in the ballpark. See what I'm saying? We're taking somebody's life. Okay. So what I'm trying to ascertain is approximately how many times. And I'm trying to ascertain the state of mind that you were in at that time.
I'm scared.
You were scared, you was on the drugs, you wanted to get away. You didn't want her to leave you. You didn't want her to leave you. You didn't want this 14-year-old girl to leave you who called mama. She called mama. You didn't want her to leave. You didn't want her to tell it because you had too much to lose as a 26, 27-year-old man, as opposed to a 14-year-old, 15-year-old that didn't even have to live yet. You know what, man? You have been through a hell of a lot through your lifetime to be dealing with this right here. The pressure that's been upon you, the pressure, because you can control your urges. Do you want to take advantage of a girl like that? Leave her like that? Leave her calling mama? That's a lot upon you. That's a lot. That's a hell of a pressure to be on you like that. You should feel somewhat better by telling us and getting it off your chest. You got to deal with it yourself, okay? You got to deal with it yourself. Despite your feeling to want to die. Well,
is that the brick you hit her with?
Is that the brick you were referring to?
I guess so.
You saying that you either hit her with the brick or the pole? Or you might hit him with both.
Yeah.
But that's the brick that you were referring to?
I guess it was down there. It was a brick down
there. Well, it could be four or five other bricks down there.
It might have been. Do I think it's a permanent?
You left it down there when you did?
I ran.
Yeah, you ran.
I can't run from here.
No, you can't. I call it therapy. Because you never know, it may bring something back in your mind.
It'll bring that back.
It definitely ain't gonna bring them back. For her to call mom, that's the only person she could think of, mom. Just like you thought about your mom.
What did she exactly say?
Just said mom.
Mom?
Mom. She said mom, right?
I know when you tell the mama that that's what's happening.
She said mama, right? How do you think that's going to affect her?
I know.
How do you think that?
I know. Really, I don't know. That's going to get you killed.
And her pants are not up.
I left her clothes up. That's $1,000. I'm telling you all this, why would I leave that out like that?
Yeah, I don't know.
Her clothes were up. Her clothes, I don't know what happened. Her clothes were, she was headed up the steps behind me. She wasn't coming up there naked. She was headed up behind me. Her clothes were on.
What time of day is this?
Her coat was on.
What time of day did you do this?
It was in the morning.
How early?
It was between 7 and 9. It was early. It was early because kids were going to school. I just came to the house from Mama. I just got that dope from dude. I had some dope. I should have used my dope instead of his. But he was giving up on me.
So it's the same dope that made you go crazy? Did you sit and count your hands a number of times?
I was taking dope and shit. But they was giving you like a quarter of $1.75, they was giving you that much for $50.
Quantity versus quality.
And I had the good shit with
it.
240-9060, that's our number, her cell phone. Can you call her? Captain. Can you call her?
Call.
Diane.
Diane.
We have a cell phone.
We're going to talk about this for a second. So are you responsible for this?
Yes.
Why do you say that?
All the evidence is there. My statement.
Did you do this?
Yes.
Did you rape her?
Yes.
And did you kill her?
Yes. Evidence points to it.
I want to know if you did it. Did you do it?
Yes, yes.
You were there. Nobody else. It was you.
Is this what you've been thinking about all these years since the incident happened? This right here. What you see before you, that's what you remember. You think about. That's what the incident you've been thinking about.
I've been thinking about my dream.
What's that?
Her dying.
Her dying. Her death. Right. So all these years you've been thinking about her death. Since it happened, her death.
How can I do something like that?
And how could you deem to do something like that? And when you took that DNA in jail, this is what you thought of.
Yeah, because I didn't know how DNA worked.
I know.
When they take it, a week later, they come back and get you.
So when they didn't come back and get you, you thought you got away with it?
No. Mm-hmm. I knew it took long.
When you got out of jail, did you think you got away with it? When we knocked on your door yesterday, did you think about it?
I knew it was you. You know
why we were knocking on your door?
Deep down inside, I seen you and your people, and you explained to me, well, we want to talk to you downtown. Yeah, I could